is the topic of biology of 9th class. So as we all know that this fluid connective tissue is a special type of tissue which maintaining the link among the different organ and the different part of our body, or it will connect the whole part of our body. So the main important component of this fluid connective tissues are the blood and the lymph. As we know that blood, it is the mobile connective tissue. Why it is mobile? Because it can move or it can flow throughout our body because it is present in the fluid form. So therefore, blood is called the fluid mobile connective tissue. And the pH of the blood is 7.4. And this blood is flowing throughout our body with the help of arteries and the vein. And the movement of the blood in our body is maintained by our heart, by the pumping system. When the heart is pumping, and there will be the pumping of heart, which will help to move the blood forward direction, and it will help to regulate the flow of blood in our body. Then blood has a two main important components, that are the plasma and the corpuscles. Plasma, which is the fluid part of the blood, and corpuscles are the cells which are present in the blood. Then 55% of the blood contains the plasma, and about 45% of the blood has the corpuscles, which are the cells, and this is the watery part or the fluid part of the blood. And the plasma contains 90% of the water and 10% of the organic and the inorganic substance like salt. Then the proteins are there, cholesterol is there, and many other like enzymes are there, hormones are there, all these are present in this plasma. Then the corpuscles, which are like RBC, then the WBC and the platelet, these are all the cells which are present in the blood. So first we know about the RBC, then WBC and the platelet. The other name of the RBC, or we can say that RBC are also known as the erythrocytes, WBC are known as the leukocytes, platelets are called the thrombocytes. So first we have to know about the RBC. The most abundant part of the blood contains the RBC, or the major part of the blood contains the RBC. And the shape of the RBC are the concave shape, and there will be no nucleus in the RBC. This is the important difference between the WBC and the RBC. Then the next important thing, the RBC are of the red in color. It is because of the proteins and the hemoglobin which is present in the blood. This heme plus globulin. Globulin is a type of protein, but heme is responsible for the color of the blood, and this hemoglobin will form the blood, and due to which the color of the blood will become red. And the lifespan of the RBC is about 120 days. After it, the RBCs are died and the new RBCs are always generated in our body, and this RBC are manufactured in the bone marrow of our body. Then the next is the WBC. Then the WBC are again divided into two types, granulocytes and the agranulocytes. These granulocytes are again of the three types, neutrophils, basophils and the adhesophils. About 62% part of the WBC contains the neutrophils, and the main important function of the neutrophils, they are the phagocytic in nature. It means that they help to kill the germs or the pathogens or the foreign particles which are entering our body. Then the basophils, about 0 to 1% part of the WBC contain the basophils, and these are the anticoagulant agent in our blood. It means that they help to coagulate the blood. Then acidophils, the 2 to 5% part of the WBC contains the acidophils, and these acidophils are responsible for the anti-allergic part of our blood, or they are responsible for allergy in our body. Then agranulocytes are again divided into two. They are the lymphocytes and the monocytes. So the lymphocytes, about 30 to 35% part of the WBC contains the lymphocytes, and these lymphocytes have has been secreting the antibodies which help in healing the wounds in our body. Then the monocytes, 3 to 7% part of the WBC contain the monocytes. This help in healing, this help in the engulfing the foreign particles in our body. Now this is the small parts of the WBC. Now we are going to know about the cellular structure of the WBC. So this WBC may be amoeboid shape, they may be rounded, and the most important thing, the WBC contain the nucleus, or they are the nucleated cells. Then this is the main difference between the WBC and RBC, that WBC contain the nucleus but RBC doesn't contain nucleus. Then second difference is that RBC have the red color but WBC are the colorless. And the lifespan of the RBC are 120 days but the lifespan of the WBC are few hours, or it may be 1 or 2 days. And this WBC are also manufactured in the bone marrow, then the lymphs and the thymus of our body. Then next is the platelets, which are also called the thrombocytes. These platelets are of minute and they are the rounded, they are also colorless, they are also non-nucleated, they may be biconcave shape and they are non-nucleated. This is again the difference between the RBC, WBC and the platelet. As the RBC does not contain nucleus, same the platelets are also not contain the nucleus. And the most and the important thing about the platelets, they are also have been clotting the blood in our body. But as we all know that these platelets are already present in our blood. So why these are not clotting the blood when it is flowing in our body? This is the main important thing about the platelet, that platelets are inactive during they are flowing in the blood, in the body. But when there will be healing or there will, sorry, when there will be any wound in our body, at that time this blood will come out from our body and it will come in contact with the atmosphere. At that time this platelets will become active and they will help in clotting the blood in our body. Then the main important function of the blood. So blood, the main important function is the this help to link all the part of our body, and it is also helpful for the transportation of all the organic and the inorganic substance throughout all the part of our body. It means that blood play important role in the transportation of minerals in our body. Second, as we know that the blood will pass through the lungs, and at that time when the respiration process is going on, at that time because of the blood there will be the exchange of gases. So blood will help in exchanging the gases, like it will carry the oxygen, it will carry oxygen and will transport to all the cells of our body, and it will take the carbon dioxide which will release to the lungs. So blood also help in the respiration process, or it will also help to transporting the oxygen and carbon dioxide to the body. Then the third important function of the blood, in which the RBC will play the important role, that this RBC will help to carry the oxygen in the blood. Then the WBC, which is the immunity power of our body, that this WBC will fight against the diseases. So this is also very important. And as we all know that the platelets, which are called the thrombocytes, they are the anti coagulating agent, or they will help in clotting the blood in our body. So this is the very important part of the this tissue, this fluid connective tissue. These are very special type of the tissue. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.